I told you that testosterone goes down in the presence of atrazine, and that causes you to not have sperm. Is that just me and frogs? Here's a guy in England studying salmon. Give him atrazine. No testosterone. This is my work on frogs. This is their work on rats. So this effect occurs across vertebrate classes. Independently, labs have shown this. What's more is, we published in this paper the following. Here's my frogs, sperm and testes, no sperm. Remember that? When you give him atrazine. This guy in Belgium showed the same thing in fish. This guy in Argentina showed the same thing in caimans, like a big alligator. Give him atrazine, no sperm. This work in rats, sperm and testes, was done in Croatia and Nigeria. Give him atrazine, no sperm. And this guy in Pakistan, with birds and quail, sperm and testes, give him atrazine, no sperm. So every vertebrate class that's been examined shows this effect. From labs around the world, peer-reviewed and published. And this is just a few examples. Now my colleague Sean Swan, while working on humans, showed the following. Again, you like p-values. She showed that men who have atrazine in their urine at a certain level have a low sperm count and can't get their wives pregnant. It's in Columbia, Missouri. I don't know what that means. That's just a correlation. But men who have 0.1 parts per billion atrazine in their urine, men who have enough atrazine in their urine to chemically castrate a frog, have a low sperm count and can't get their wives pregnant. It's just a correlation. But we have lab data that show there's a cause and effect. What's more is, the data punched out now. This is the level of atrazine in field workers in California. Not my work, somebody else published it. Punch that down. These are the atrazine levels of men who apply atrazine. 2,400 parts per billion. Men who apply atrazine have 24,000 times the atrazine in their urine that we know is associated with low sperm count in Missouri. Men who apply atrazine have 24,000 times the atrazine in their urine that we use to chemically castrate and feminize frogs. Men who apply atrazine in California have 24,000 times the atrazine we use in the laboratory. One of these guys can pee in a bucket. I can dilute the atrazine in their urine 24,000 times, and they're carrying enough atrazine to chemically castrate and feminize 24,000 buckets of 30 tadpoles each. Nobody knows anything about the reproductive health or the health of these men because they're primarily Mexican-American, 90%. Some with life expectancies for migrant farm workers age 50. And in addition to atrazine, they're exposed to a whole host of other chemicals like papyrus, which was originally designed.